Hi, I'm Louise from SuperHigh, and in this video, I'm going to explain how and when you might want to adjust your line height. When you set a typeface to a certain size, you may notice that in your design or code program, it assigns a default value to properties like tracking and line height. While these characteristics work well the majority of the time, sometimes they require some additional tweaking based on their use case. Let's focus on the one you might find yourself interacting with the most, which is line height. Line height can be measured in points, pixels, percentages, ems and rems. The relationship between the text size and the line height usually ranges from 1.2 to 1.6 times the font size, depending on the size of your font and the X height. Generally speaking, a larger font size may benefit from having a smaller line height, whereas a smaller font would benefit from having a greater line height. This has to do with readability and the ways users visually group pieces of text together. For example, if you see here, we've got some text styled in Cooper Black, in size 72, in both a line height that is 60% larger than the font size at 115 pixels and 20% larger than the font size at 86 pixels. Note that you can enter the formula of 72 times 1.6 or 72 times 1.2 in the line height value in Figma to get the values, or enter 160 or 120%. In the first example, the line height is not so great. The text is difficult to group together and see as one headline. Whereas in the second example, the text is a bit tighter while still being easy to read and avoiding collisions. Collisions occur when the line height is too tight, causing the ascenders and descenders of various lines to touch. If we shorten the line height to 56, you can see how this starts to get a little bit problematic. Not only is the line height scrunched, but the characters of each line begin to collide. We've also got two examples of copy text here. In the first example, the line height is 1.2 times the font. Here we can see that the text feels a bit too tight, which makes it a little tough to read through. Whereas in the second example, the line height is set to 1.6 times the font. In this example, the text is breathing a bit better and easier to read, while still maintaining a sense of togetherness. The reader can recognize this to be one paragraph easily. There are other factors to consider besides text size when determining your line height. For example, line length, also known as measure. Or you might want to consider the size of the device which your text is meant to be displayed and read on. Generally, longer lines need more generous line spacing. But there are no hard and fast rules for determining the correct line height. These are just some guiding principles in choosing the best line height for your experience. As you can see, line height plays an important part in helping the user pass through information on your site. While the default line height can work the majority of the time, sometimes it needs extra adjustments to improve the reading experience.